Hello learners, I welcome you all in yet another video lesson of D.El.Ed program of course code 504, unit 11, Tools and Techniques of Assessment. In today's lesson, we are going to discuss about developing question banks in mathematics. But before discussing the concept, let me discuss with you the proposed flow of the lesson. First of all, I would discuss with you the lesson guide, then the expectations in terms of learning objectives would be shared with you. Then we will discuss about the meaning and concept of question banks. Then the importance of question banks would be discussed with you. We would also discuss about the development of question banks and the use of question bank. And at the end, I would recapitulate and there would be a take-home task for you. Let me discuss with you the lesson guide. During my presentation, I will explain and exemplify the different concepts. You should follow my voice and the slides as well. You will find important words and sentences, etc., have been highlighted to facilitate your retention. I have also summarized the main points at the end to have a quick glance for better retention. There are some questions or exercises in between and at the end of my presentation. You are advised to attempt these questions or exercises after going through this video lesson. Now, there are learning objectives. After the completion of this video lesson, you would be able to know the concept of question banks in mathematics. You are also able to get acquainted with the process of development of question bank in mathematics. You will also be able to get acquainted with the usage of question bank in mathematics. Before moving on the concept, let me construct an analogy for you. Let's assume I earn a sum of rupees 100 every day and need only rupees 50 to fulfill all my daily needs. What would I do with the excess sum of rupees 50 daily which I have? Obviously, I am keeping this spare sum as saving and depositing it at a single place. Now, one day suddenly, I receive some guest at home and immediately need an extra sum of rupees 500, which is extra from what I usually spend every day. What I will do? Yes, I will be withdrawing this extra sum of rupees 500 from the deposit of my regular saving. The situation is an approximation of the learning and assessment situation where achievement of learning objective is intermittently assessed. The accurate estimation of the levels of the objectives achieved requires continuous preparation for the assessment in terms of developing assessment tools, instruments, and facilitators. And here comes the concept of question bank, which is nothing but a facilitator or a tool of assessment in the assessment of mathematics of learning. Now, coming on the concept of question bank. Question bank refers to a pool or deposit of various kind of test item generated or developed on regular basis and to be used as and when the assessment needs arises. It's a continuous pool which have been made by the teacher or by the expert in which we deposit all kind of test items, that is MCQs or multiple choice answer type question or the open test items or other types of items, and we use when the assessment needs arise. Now, coming on the definitions of question bank, a question bank is defined as an organized collection of test items, and it can be used when the assessment of test is required. Please attend to the definition given by B.H. Chopin, who is defining question bank as an organized, classified, and cataloged item bank, which facilitate the construction of variety of achievement and other type of mental test. That is, when a test is designed, we used to dig or draw the question from the question bank. It is a kind of bank which is readily available with us to draw something when it is needed. Now, to continue the definition, A question bank is a plant library. Please attend the word plant library of the test items designed to fulfill certain predetermined purpose. The purpose to design a question bank is pre-specified, and for that specified purpose, we design and then use the question bank to make the test items or the test papers. The question bank also make available statistically sound questions or items of known technical worth and thus facilitate selection of proper question for a well-designed question paper. The items which have been contained by the question bank are statistically sound or the validated item. That is, they are able to achieve or assess what is supposed to be assessed, and they are readily available and bankable. So the question bank can be seen as the exhaustive stock of the large number of variety of reliable and valid test items which are intended to be used for assessment. Reliability refers to that we can rely on the test, that is, it is supposed to assess what we want to assess, and validity, that in different context tested by different people, it gives a same kind of results. Now, coming on the question bank, how to prepare the question bank, or what are the points to be kept in mind while preparing the question bank? Question bank should be prepared with utmost care to cover the entire prescribed text. It should not be selective in its nature. It should be exhaustive. It should be holistic. It should cover all the aspects of that prescribed text for which we are preparing the question bank. Question bank should be exhaustive and cover the entire content with different types. It should be based on sound ideas, purpose, and adapted to the particular objective of mind. That is, it should focus on a particular purpose. It should not be goalless. It should aim to achieve a particular goal or objective. The question bank should be within the range of the student's experiences and knowledge. The question bank should use a variety of the test items. Say, for example, a question bank shouldn't necessarily include all the MCQs. It should have provision for open test items also, and under the MCQ, it should have mix and match kind of things. It should have fill in the blanks things. So variety of test items should be there in the question bank so that we can assess the different kind of objectives by using a question bank. The question bank should contains items which can challenge and hence stimulates the educative response with reference to the objective. Question bank should not contain the simple items. Question bank should not contain the very knowledge-based item. The items and the language of items, options and distractors which are involved in the items contained by the question bank should be able to challenge the performance or of the learners so that they can go ahead and they can improve their performance. The question bank should be separately developed for each separate ideas or concepts. That is, an exhaustive kind of exercise should be done to develop a large number of items for different concepts and different ideas. Developing question bank, it's a continuous process. It's not one-time process. We need to add on items in the question bank continuously. And question bank should be based on action. That is, a question bank should be there in action. A question bank should be used. It should not be kept idle. Then how to use question bank and where we can use the question bank. The question bank can be used to improve teaching and learning process. Now the question comes, how the question bank can improve the teaching and learning process? By using question bank, the test items are readily available to us, and as a teacher, we can use as and when the test items are required, even within the class, even while teaching a concept, During the progression, in the beginning, at the recapitulation time, every time we can use the readily available question items or the test items which are there in the question bank. The question bank can also facilitate students' growth. How? Because the question bank can also be used to self-assessment by the student by using the test item contained by the question bank, or otherwise the teacher can give the feedback on the basis of the test which have been done by the items or through the items which are there in the question bank, and hence on the basis of the feedback received, the student can facilitate their growth and their learning. The question bank can improve evaluation process. That is, by using the question bank, we can have more quality, and also we can frame more good questions or the quality questions or the quality items for doing evaluation or assessment. The question bank can also assess students' performance formatively and summatively. As discussed earlier, we can use question bank in between while the learning is going on, and we can also use question bank when the learning of a particular concept is over and students are supposed to be assessed summatively. The question bank provides a handy pool of authentic test items which can be used as and when required. Hence, the question bank saves planning and preparation time. It is a readily available pool with us. We can dig out items, we can use the items there in the question bank as and when required as a teacher. Now coming on how the question bank are developed. There are some principles which is there on your screen. For developing the question bank, the first principle is we are required to spend adequate amount of time for developing the question or the test items. See, it's not a short time exercise. If we won't devote time, we won't be able to generate quality items, we won't be able to generate different kind of items which can assess our learners effectively. So, it is required to spend an adequate amount of time when we are developing a different kind of question for a question bank. The second principle is to match the questions to the content. That is, we should be concerned about the content for which the question bank is being developed, and all the items should specifically be devised or be attached with that particular content. No item should be out of the content or out of the context. So, we are required to focus or to match the content with the items which are in the question bank. While developing the question bank, we should try to make the question valid, reliable, and balanced. That is, the question should have the capacity to test what is required to be tested. The question should have the capacities which are there in the question bank, should have the capacity to authenticate or the student's assessment or the student's evaluation result, that as and when the test items are used, they should give us the same kind of result or the results on the similar line, that there should not be any diversion, and the question should be balanced, or the test item which are there in the question bank should be balanced in terms of difficulties, in terms of coverage of the content, and in terms of the different learning domains which are required to be assessed through the question bank. The question bank, while making the question bank, we should use a variety of testing methods. That is, we should not rely on a single method of testing. We should use a different variety of methods for developing a question bank. While developing a question bank, we should write questions that test skills other than recall. As discussed earlier, we should not focus in assessment merely on the knowledge domain. We should go beyond that. That is, our question bank should be capable of testing or assessing the comprehension abilities, the application abilities, the analysis, synthesis, and evaluation abilities of our learners. While developing question bank or while framing questions for the question bank, it has to be ensured that they are unambiguous, simple in the language, and brief as far as possible. Very long questions and the questions which use tough language are very difficult or unnecessarily distracts the student, and there are possibilities where our good students are also not able to perform different kind of items or to solve different kind of problems merely because of the toughness of the language or the ambiguity into the language. So while framing the question which are there in the question bank or supposed to be there in the question bank, we should be pretty simple in our languages, unambiguous, and we should be as short as possible while framing the stem of a question. Now, while making the question bank or while generating the items in the question bank, we should understand or we should keep into the mind that each of the question should have or should evaluate some specific content area of the learning outcome. It is really concerned with the coverage of the concept, and it should ensure that specific content area or the learning outcome is measured by a pool of item, or the part of item should be focused on some specific content area or the learning outcome. Now moving on the principles, further we are discussing the principles of making the question bank. While framing the question bank, we should keep into consideration the difficulty level of the items in the bank, and it should challenge the group of the learner being tested to learn and to acquire higher order thinking skills. We should not facilitate our students to be where they are. We should push them to go ahead. So the items in the question bank should be like that, which are, you know, difficult in nature, and we should challenge the group of the learners which have been or which are supposed to be tested through the items which are there in the question bank. While writing the items, we should keep into the mind that items should be categorized as per their nature, that is, all the objectives should be grouped in one section, while the short answer type questions and the essay type questions should be in another section. And in the section of objective type test items, which are having the same format, that is, which are having yes and no as answer category, which are having true and false as answer category, or otherwise multiple choice type answer categories, they should be grouped together so that our question banks looks logical in its nature. The items in each section should be arranged in order to their difficulty, that is, we should arrange the items in our question bank from simple to complex, from knowledge based questions to comprehension to application to analysis, synthesis and evaluation. That is, the more simpler skills or the domain should fall first, and the more complex or higher order mental skills, the items which test the higher order mental skills should be progressively be shown in the question bank or included in the question bank or the placed into the question bank. Now, coming on the preparation, that how we prepare the question bank, there are three primary steps while preparing the question bank, and in the progressively in this lesson, we will discuss all the three steps one by one in detail. The three steps which are there while preparing the question bank are planning a question bank. The second step is development of a question bank, in which we include blueprinting a question bank, collection of test items, recording and sorting of test items, validation of test items, reviewing the question paper, and the third step for preparing a question bank is developing a system for maintaining confidentiality. Now coming on the planning stage, while planning, we need to outline what needs to be done. The planning refers to the process of defining what needs to be done or what is expected in action from us. Therefore, planning includes the development of guidelines, references or standards for the proposed course of action. Objective of the question bank should be clearly visualized. This comes under planning only. We need to clearly visualize or identify or spell the objective of the question bank, that what for our question bank is developed because it is going to determine the nature of the items and the usage of question bank. Appropriate place should be identified about the location of the bank, that is where the question bank should locate, in school, with the respective teacher or with the school, where we are going to keep our question bank. In the school, whether it is a property of the school or it is a property of the respective teacher which has developed the questionnaire or the question bank, or it is the property of the school. And outside the school, whether it is the property of the state or state board, wherever it is to be kept, the location should be like that. It should be accessible to all those who are interested in using that particular question bank. In today's time, we are going technology savvy, we are becoming technology savvy. That's why the question bank should be, it is good if they are available technologically, if they are available on web or on the website of either the state boards or the school or on the web portals or the pages of a particular teacher. While developing the question bank, identifying and arrangement of suitable space and equipments for sorting and classifying questions should be done. It is done on the planning stage, that how we are going to arrange the suitable space where the question bank is kept, what kind of equipment we are going to use for sorting and classifying different questions, because developing question bank is a confidential exercise, so it should be done with an utmost care and with a sound planning base. Coming on the development phase, the development consists of selection of items for question bank, depends on the frame of reference envisaged at the planning stage, where the scope and purpose of usage of the question bank are also determined. At planning stage, we define the scope and purpose of the usage of the question bank, and on the basis of that, we generate different kind of test items which should be kept under the question bank, and therefore it is said that development of question bank is dependent about the sound planning of the question. The development refers to what is to be used, is defining about what is to be used, whether the question bank should be used only for the written examination, oral examination, practical examination, or for all. And accordingly, different kind of test items are generated and should be kept under the question bank. Now coming on the very important aspect of development of question bank, which is blueprinting for question bank. A blueprint is a schematic representation of what constitutes the question bank and in what proportion. A blueprint can also be called as question bank specification. It may consist of a matrix or chart representing the number of questions you want in your question bank within each topic and level of objective. The blueprint identifies the objectives and skills that are to be tested and the relative weight on the test given to each of the skills or objective. The blueprint can help you ensure that you are obtaining the desired coverage of topic and level of objectives. Just look at your screen. I have an example of blueprint for you. In this table, you can see that I have categorized or made my blueprint according to the objective domains. There are three topics for your reference: topic A, topic B, and topic C. In knowledge domain, I have given four items under topic A, four items under topic B, and four items under topic C. There are 12 items in total in knowledge domain, which converts into the percentage, represent 12% of the total of the question bank. Then there are items for comprehension as specified under topic A, B, and C, which comes around 18% of the total coverage. Then items of application, which comes around 38% of the total coverage. Then items of analysis, which comes around 25%, synthesis, which comes around 5%, and evaluation, which comes around 2% of the total coverage, and these make together as 100% of the total coverage. After the development of the question bank, blueprint writing of the items begins, and the development of question banks also include various sources who can write the test items. The various sources of the test items are there to facilitate the writing of the question. We can use the ready-to-use question sources such as old question papers, standardized tests, review exercises of good textbooks, or we can generate new questions. New questions can be generated through experienced teachers, by examiners and paper setters, by practicing teachers, or by the teachers himself or herself. Otherwise, the question or the items must fit into the specification of the question bank, whatever source is to be used, whether it is a ready-to-use question source or whether the new questions are generated by the experts, experienced teachers, or by the teachers himself or herself. It should fit into the specification of the question bank, that the purpose of the question bank for which it is supposed to be used. And each question should be accompanied by an answer key. No question bank is complete without the answer key. So each item should be company or should be given company with its answer, and in toto all the answers makes an answer key beside indicating objective and the content area. Now coming on screening of the questions and the validation of the items. While validating our items or for validating our items, we are required to share and discuss the items generated with the peers and the expert. These experts could be test experts and subject experts both. Then we are required to validate our test items to incorporate of the comments so received. The comments which have been received by discussing our test items with the peer or the experts should be incorporated to change the test item. These could be in form of modification. These changes could be in form of modification, addition or deletion. Then we are required for validation the pilot testing. Pilot testing is in testing on a small group of the question bank to validate or to make it more reliable, and that result of the pilot testing are analyzed to again change our question banks or the item. Then there would be an item analysis in which we calculate the discrimination value and the difficulty index of each item, and accordingly we can change our test item, modify our test item, or add or delete our test item according to the value we get as discrimination index or discrimination value and difficulty index. Now coming on preparing question cards and sorting. As we have discussed that development also includes sorting, we are going to discuss on how the question cards or sorting is done. We are finalizing question bank, or the questions may now be transferred to cards. Make a thick chart paper which is cut into pieces of 8 inches to 5 inches size, which could be fairly of a size of an envelope. Then the question card may use different color schemes in preparing cards for different objectives and various form of question. That is, we can use for essay type question dark green color, for short answer type question blue color, and for objective type test pink color. The color codes facilitate identification and sorting of the question. That is, a teacher need not to struggle when he or she is required to choose items. On the basis of the color of the card, she would be able or he would be able to identify that what kind of item is locating where, and he or she can easily choose the items from its location. Then the question card also facilitates the effective engagement at all the children at a time, that we can give different kind of cards to different children and we can engage all the learner at a time, at a single time. Then question card are also required to accord coding to facilitate sorting so that they can keep in order. How to use question bank and what for question banks are used? Let me discuss that also. For instructional purposes, we can use question bank for pre-testing, development, review, and revision of a lesson. To facilitate interaction in the class, we can use the question banks. We can use the question bank to facilitate self-evaluation and revision by the students themselves. We can also use the question bank for preparing review exercises in the textbooks. Question banks can also be used to evaluate people's progress and to provide feedback on their performance. To sum up, In today's lesson, we have discussed the concept of question bank, which can be understood as a pool of deposit of variety of authentic test items to be used as and when need arises. The need and purpose of question bank have also been discussed in detail. The eternal principles which are required to be taken into consideration while developing question banks, such as exhaustive coverage, matching the difficulty, balance, and ensuring reach to all who are interested in usage, have also been highlighted. The process to prepare the question bank, that is, the process of planning, blueprinting, writing test items, validation, and coding, have also been discussed. And at the end, the usage of question bank has been highlighted. Now it's time to take home exercise. I expect you to prepare a question bank containing 50 items on the topic circle and its properties for the class of 7th to assess their knowledge, comprehension, application, and acquisition of mathematical skill. And I thank you all for attending this video lesson. Make maths as a fun for your students. Thank you very much.